Get away from your boring ass. They put that guy on the rock. Now, who? The guy that buys the slot machines? Him? Waitress, another drink. Yeah, I don't know what kind of talking about. Well, he's very well dressed. Casino pit boss. What can I do for you, hon? Still a slot machine. I could be the private dancer. Can you tell me a little about the casino? Best goddamn casino in town. Best goddamn tables. No one run along now. Check them out, alright? Who owns this casino? The Bishop family. They pumped a lot of life into this place. Made it a real night spot. A shining jewel in New Reno. Who are you? I'm the pit boss. Now what can I do for you? Nothing, thanks. Sorry to bother you. Old guy with the slot machines. I wonder if he's behind. I'm hitting the cat's paw after work. Maybe this guy? Maybe he needs a new pair of shoes. Slot machines. Maybe it's a different row of slot machines. Roll the bones, because they're just more... Old Man McGee. Oh, okay. Just one more pull. Eh? What do you want, girlie? Who are you? A series of symbols roll by on the slot machine, and there was a bzzz, damn it, stomach machine. I'll get my chips back any day now. How long have you been doing this? Close now to 5 years. I reckon any day now this machine's gonna break, and when it does, pay dirt. good luck to you then. What are you doing? Mind if I give it a pull? He sneers. Let you touch my machine? And jinx my luck? Hell no. Get out of here. Alright then. What luck? Besides bad, that is. Did I mention ghouls stink? Oh, there's another pit boss, dude. I can't select them while they walk like that. I guess it's the same guy, because he's not over there anymore. Alright. I guess he just walks back and forth between here and the pit. Alright, we could use someone like you. Sounds more promising than the other place. Still hearing people falling. Two bathrooms. What's so rad about them? This place is empty? A fairly ordinary wooden table. Need some more chips at table 3. Or so rad. Empty. 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 Oh, desks. Empty. These are all empty. That's why there's no one guarding them. Just checking them all in case there's one with stuff in it. But nope. Alright, let's go talk to this guy, I guess. What's up with that? fence. He's too busy in his routine to talk right now. Oh, comedian. Super mutants? Okay. Good crowd today. What's so super about them? When was the last time you saw a super mutant? No one seems to be paying attention to that guy. Get a cat out of a tree? Never. Know why? Why? Because super mutants don't rescue cats. They kill mercilessly. Alright. Yeah, he's hilarious. Why would anyone kill you, mercilessly? So who calls them super mutants? Who are these people? Let's see where he's going with this. So, there was this prostitute, right? This stupid slut. Your mom's a slut. Heckling. And, she goes, right. She goes, is that a gecko in your pocket, or are you just, horny. You suck. Good thing he's got that cage. Did I mention it was a fire-breathing gecko? Eh. So, why did the rad scorpion cross the road? This is funny. I mean, the punchlines suck, but it's kind of okay until it gets there. You know what I'm saying? Why the rad scorpion crossed the road? That in itself, because the rad scorpion, it wanted to get away from the radioactive fallout particles. Yeah, it's lame. Anything else? The joke. See, since it was already a mutant, it didn't need to cross the road, so... Well, they did laugh at that. Vertibirds? Verti what? What the hell is this guy talking about? How about those little bags of peanuts they serve on flights? What about the salami you get served? What's up with that? Yeah, it's stupid. Alright, he's back to his super mutants thing. This lamp looks like it's in good working condition. Let's check upstairs. Does this asshole ever stop telling you stupid jokes? You see a Nuka-Cola machine, you wonder if it still works. A nicely made table. Handmade, but looks much nicer than any table you've seen before. So these guys are a lot nicer than the other men. At least so far. It's definitely a table. Angela Bishop. Why does she sound familiar? Angela Bishop. Haven't seen you around before. You want a daddy's new horse? Okay. The only good answer is no, just passing through. Kinda like shit through the intestines, huh? Don't stay too long, bitch. Well, you're gonna get hurt. Whatever. If someone's mentioned this Angela Bishop, I can't remember now. Maybe not, I don't know. Looking for work, etc. Come to my bedroom. Oh my. Will she let me just take this stuff? That would be something if she did. Only saving in case I get attacked and die. So I have to play it all over again. Because look what we got. An empty hypodermic, 3 jet, Xander root, Brock flower, a lighter, and a knife. That worked out okay. Stay away from there. Okay. So, we haven't had a lighter yet. A silver butane lighter in good condition. Empty hypodermic? Good stuff. I can sell this stuff. Especially the jet. Wasn't there a jet in there? No, maybe not. I think there was one. Yeah, I think it added to what I had. I wasn't paying too much attention. It's just stuff, you know? Stuff. Stay away from there. But this is okay? That's 10 millimeter, though. Brass knuckles. This stuff's okay, though. I can take this money and this brass knuckles. Hardened knuckle grip is actually made out of steel. It protects your hand and do more damage in unarmed combat. Sweet. Guess we're gonna run into 2 episodes. Catch the fight last night. The door appears to be locked. And there's another floor. What do you want, hon? Make it quick. What's up those stairs? If you don't know, then you don't need to know. Now blow. I'm here to see Mr. Bishop. No, I know Mr. Bishop's schedule, and you ain't on it. Alright then, goodbye. The other people kept telling me to go see him if I want to work. They will not barter. Will this guy barter? You again. No, you want now. I want to barter, goddammit. A pool table. Oh. I could take a magic 8-ball? Okay. I got a magic 8-ball. That's awesome. This black sphere is some strange precognitive device. A small window on the top seems to be able to predict the future. Pre-war humanity must have been geniuses to invent such a wonder. Yeah, can I use it? Temporarily out of service. Yes. Will I die during this episode? Yes, definitely. Okay. Great. I guess this is locked too. I'm not picking it with them standing there. Then my fortune will definitely come true. Yeah, I've been trying to look for him. Empty. 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 Stay away from there. Huh. Oh, he lets me. It's empty. That's why. Just a broken table? Is it a broken table? Hmm. Alright. Continuing our exploration. I wonder if I can just go upstairs if those people will try to stop me. Stay away from there. What about here? Stay away from there, too. What about over here? Not, this is okay. Okay, so I have a good amount of ammo. This is 10 millimeter. .61 for the .44 Magnum. Okay, so I've got more 10 millimeter here. Doing well. That's what I really wanted the most. Was ammo. I needed it. Stay away from there. Stay away from there. And stay away from there. Alright. See you guys later. Judging from the crowd, what'd you say? Mrs. Bishop. The woman turns to face you. She is quite attractive, with a low-cut dress made of gold gecko skin. She studies you for a moment, then frowns. Yes? What is it? Can't believe you're wearing gecko skin. That's disgusting. Who are you? We're just walking into a place and saying, who are you? It's kind of rude. She raises an eyebrow. I think I should be the one asking that question. She crosses her arms. I am Leslie Ann Bishop. My husband is the head of the Bishop family here in New Reno. And you are? My name is Andrea King. Andrea King. So, Andrea King, what, pray tell, do you think I can do for you? Okay, I'm not supposed to ask about her father or the Bishop family. Do you know where I could find something called the Garden of Eden creation kit? Stupid question. I know where you could find a creation kit, but it will do you a little good. It has already been used. Where is this Garden of Eden creation kit? She smiles faintly, as if remembering something pleasant. Have you ever been to Vault City? It is northeast of New Reno. They had such a kit once, long ago, but they used it when they left their vault for the surface. Can you tell me about Vault City? Her smile fades and her expression becomes hard and distant. There's not much to tell. I think you'd find the climate there different. Now, is that all? No, actually, I had some other questions. Yes? Have you heard of a place called Vault 13? As I said, there is Vault City to the northeast. Is that the place you are referring to? It could be. You might want to head there, then. Okay. Very well. Thanks for your time. I appreciate it. Hold on a moment. She studies you. You seem to be new in town. Would you care to join me for a drink in my chambers? We can discuss New Reno. It's a dangerous place for those unfamiliar with its ways. Okay, well, this is unexpected. Only if the drinks are just the beginning. What would I mean by that? I wonder. I already know the answer. Yeah, why not? She's attractive, right? Only if the drinks are just the beginning. She raises an eyebrow. We shall see. Well, that's all I need to hear. Let's go. She nods and smiles. Very well. Follow me. Now, am I going to piss him off? Because that was an option to say I don't want to piss him off. Follow her. You join Mrs. Bishop for a drink in her chambers. The two of you talk for a while. Then she comes over and starts caressing you. Well, I wouldn't want to piss her off, so... Embrace her? This is going to end badly. I have a feeling. Something, the biggest, what? Passionate lovemaking commences. At the end of your sexual marathon, Mrs. Bishop curls up against you, smiling contentedly. Andrea King. Leslie. This is very unexpected. Mrs. Bishop sighs contentedly and stretches. She would react negatively to me asking her anything about her family. You're not... Of course I would ask her. Yeah, I'm thinking maybe I shouldn't have taken that perk. Well, I can't untake it, right? Or can I? I'm not even sure. You're not from New Reno, are you, Mrs. Bishop? You talk differently from a lot of people around here. No, I don't talk like everyone around here. It's called an education. She rolls over. Go to sleep. Where could I get an education? You're already as smart as I want you to be. Now go to sleep. If you're pumping me for information, then you're creating a deficit. Deficit? Here in the bed? I did not. Mrs. Bishop sighs contentedly and stretches. Are you from Vault City? She cracks open one eye. Who told you that? I guess after I heard you talk about Vault City. You got that nostalgic look in your eye. Her expression crumbles for a moment, then she rolls over so you can't see her. Don't mention that place. What happened? John happened. I used to live there. He visited once. I was pleasantly charmed because he was so... rough, I guess. Different from most Vault citizens. Of course, he let me try some drugs and... And? Drugs were legal in Vault City, of course. The other citizens found out and revoked my citizenship. John was the only one I could turn to. He knew that, of course. He planned the whole thing. So you got your education in Vault City? That's why you sound different than everyone else here in New Reno? They had memory enhancers for the Pip-Boys there. Had dictionaries and encyclopedias stored on them. Took one of the lingual enhancers when I left. Though I don't know why. Where is this enhancer? She curls up. It's in my safe. Not much use without a Pip-Boy, though. Don't know why I still keep it. Can I have it? She shrugs. Sure, if you want them. Combination is 57-42-26. The enhancer is in a compartment in the bottom of the safe. A thief isn't going to find it unless they know what to look for. Alright, I'm writing that down in case the game won't remember for me. 57-42-26. You know, she keeps yawning, making me yawning. How do I use it? Just attach the headgear, place the optic sensor over your right eye, then connect the other end. Humph. She rolls over to the Pip-Boy. You feel a slight rush, some nausea, then your head will feel clearer. Interesting. Alright. Where's the vault again? The safe? Got some other questions? It's in her safe. Maybe in this room? Your question is met with silence. Mrs. Bishop has fallen asleep. You can't help but wonder if she would have stayed awake longer if you'd been more... skilled. But you quickly repress the thought before it hurts your ego. Slip out of bed quietly. Oh well. So? I'm a wanderer. Oh wait. Is this where it said I was a virgin of the wastes? Because I can't find that now. Alright. Look around for stuff and safe. More stuff in that room. Well, there's all kinds of goodies. This is working out for me. I haven't even found the safe yet. Really intrigued with this thing. This Pip-Boy. Enhancement. Again, Andrea King. She's talking in her sleep about me. We got some rot gut. A very strong liquor or cleaning fluid. You decide. That's the one I just looked in, right? And so where is this safe? Well, that must be it. You see a combination safe set securely into the wall. It is closed. Not for long, it isn't. Andrea King. It is locked.